Oh, hit the SD card there.
It's in there. You can just press that one.
I already did.
It's already, it's in there.
I know, but I pressed it and it's blinking red now. Over here. Does that mean it's working?
We'll see. If we get like a power warning, we'll turn that off. James, Craig, Frank, we're here from Tunkhannock. We're ready to start in about 5 minutes.
Everybody focused, everybody go, do your job.
Right behind the Tunkhannock bench. So this could be a
very competitive game.
It could be. Tunkhannock had high hopes coming into this season.
Struggled a little bit so far.
Yeah, well, I mean, they had a... They played Crystal pretty competitively. With 7-0 late in the second quarter against Hazleton last week, and the wheels kind of came off. But what I mean is they're a dangerous team. They're 0-2. They had high hopes for the season. They're at home. They know that their time is drawing near to right the ship here. So Craig's on the camera. James will be doing color, and I'll be play-by-play. I'm going to try not to knock the laptop on the screens. Tunkhannock gave us some power. Appreciate that. So it looks like Tunkhannock will receive. They have three deep.
Back to receive for the Tigers, Riley Jones and Nate Lord.
Nathan Lord is one of their big playmakers. He's number 15. Riley Jones, 81.
I think this is meant for you.
And Jaden's number 43.
If they're in there, you're in there.
Oh, look who made it to a game this year.
We're finally allowed.
We might need that
exile.
Power thing at some point.
You know, ooh,
to make this into a...
Kicking off,
we might need that strip at some point. Can we use your
motion.
Power strip?
Yeah, if you guys... I brought it just to charge this.
Yeah, we might need it.
We definitely
need it. Thanks, coach. Here, so Jaden Russell will have the kickoff. We're just about underway here at Tunkhannock Stadium. Craig on the camera. Here's the whistle and the boot from Jaden. And that's going to come down at about the 6-yard line. That's Nathan Lord. He's looking for some room up in the middle. He's got some room. Now he comes on this near sideline. Adam Sigmund going to shove him out of bounds. Good job by Adam Sigmund getting down from his position.
To the 26-yard line, first and 10
that's
Tigers.
Where, huh?
Will you lose signal if you unplug it?
Well, I think we'll be good for the first half. We might just check in a second. So that's
where
the...
Yeah, you probably have to check it for a second.
We might just plug everything in there. Jack Chilson will have charge of Tunkhannock.
We can't unplug it now. We can't unplug it.
27-yard line.
Because it'll die. If you came over...
We might use it for halftime, though.
Like I said, I didn't understand what Coach Fonte meant, but...
Maybe that's what he wanted to, yeah.
Yeah, I didn't understand. Yeah, he wanted all the coaches on that side.
So Chilson has a single setback behind him. Four receivers. He'll kick one in motion here, and it's going to be the give to number 44, and he's tackled pretty quickly there by Nick Elko.
Hand out to number 44, Bobby Schultz.
Bobby did a great job of closing the film.
Elko. Second and nine.
And Tunkhannock really doesn't run the ball a whole lot, so so they're not going to be able to. That's going to force them into some third and long situations. One of the strengths of this Warrior team thus far has been the pass rush and pass defense. Same set now for Tunkhannock. Chilson picks up a three-step drop, and he's looking over the middle here, and it's in and out of the hands of number 35, Jacob Belcher.
Chilson's pass intended for Jacob Belcher's incomplete.
So that will bring up down third and long for Tunkhannock on their first series. Now we've got three receivers to that far side for Chilson. He's got one sidecar with him.
Benny Tunkhannock.
Call something out, a little bit of an audible. Short drop, looking, he has some time. Now he's gonna roll to his left. He's gonna look for some running room. And he's gonna have a little bit, had more than I thought he would have there.
Chilson on the keeper. Trying to
force that, chase him out. Looks like Blaze Sokash Minute got in there pretty nicely.
Condry brings up a fourth down.
Short of the sticks. And they'll have to kick it away. So good defensive series by the Wyoming Area, James.
Yeah, absolutely. They did a great job of staying home, staying disciplined, filling in the gaps when they need to. They didn't overpursue the quarterback on their blitzes.
Rocco Pisano and Adam Sigmund now. They're going to set up about the 35-yard line. They should have decent field position. A little end over end. Looks like Adam Sigmund is going to call a fair catch, and that's the right call there. They'll have take possession
at the 36-yard line. By number 88, Adam Sigmund. The Warriors take over first and 10.
Really only like a 30-yard punt, and there wasn't much air under it, so there was really no hang time. I think Adam made the right decision there to fair catch it. And they're in decent field position to start their first series. Looks like Nasir Condry is back. That's good for the Warriors.
Warriors take over at the 36-yard line.
Tunkhannock has been good against the run this year against the best of Hazleton. So we'll see how that turns out early in the contest. High formation behind Jacob Williams. Looks like Gashai and Maruk. Here's the gift to Maruk over right guard. He's hit hard there. Number 31, Marcus Hernandez. Tunkhannock.
31, Michael Sickler.
Put out.
Brings up a second down and nine for the Warriors.
What defense?
Michael Sickler. Is that Michael Sickler?
Michael Sickler, yeah.
That would be
So that's going to be an interesting thing to watch early in this game. Is can the Warriors run on the Tigers? Okay, it looks like Gashai there. Still in that I formation. Adam Sigmund's on your near side. Here, there's the pitch to Drew Maruk. He's looking for room. He cuts back. He's going to have three or four. Push. We'll call it 4 yards. Maybe five.
Maybe five brings up a third down to five.
Five now for the Warriors. 10:15 left in this first quarter. We've got no score.
So Cannon's doing a great job backing in the box. Going to the cover zero on it. Look for a play action here.
Play action. Rocco and Adam are getting open. And now they're a champ pair here on this near side.
No safety over top.
And Jacob is going to be in the shotgun. And he's going to roll to his right. And he's looking for Pisano. And it looks like that was
Jacob Williams pass. Jack Chilson broken up by Jack Chilson brings up a fourth down.
Thomas picked it up. So three out here for the Warriors. Neither team was able to get a first down on their first possession. 9:48. No score. Punt now, end over end. That could be there's running into the kicker. There's a flag down. Jaden Russell got rid of it, and he got hit by two Tigers there very quickly. And that could be a big break for the Warriors here early.
Kicked by number 43, Keegan Russell. There is a flag on the play.
He got it off, and yeah, he's pointing. So that's a rough one for Tunkhannock here to give up the first down.
Could be aggressive, but not at that point.
They haven't moved the sticks yet. They wave it off. Flag went down.
Push up, back, Tiger team attack. Push up, back, Tiger team attack.
Is there a call yet?
Push up, back, Tiger team attack.
Yeah, they're marking it off
call,
now.
So there you go.
Is it just 5 yards or 10? Yeah, it's 10. Yeah, so that's a definite first down.
Should be 15, right?
Mm-hmm. Penalty on the Tigers, roughing the kicker. will give the Warriors a first down.
So that moves the Warriors into Tiger territory at the 44-yard line. 15 yards, I should know that. I should know that, Steve Holmes. Little pro set formation now with Leo Harris and Kobe Gashai. Pisano and Sigmund are split to your side here. Williams, low drop and rolls, and now he's going to get it off to Russin, and he's going to be on the run there. He got a first down and more, and he could go and hit the pylon. He's going to be knocked out. It's a touchdown.
Jacob Williams pass.
What a play.
Number 43, Keegan Russin.
Jaden Russin.
For the touchdown.
Yeah, well, they gave Jaden Keegan's number tonight, so it's Jaden. Just tell him it's Jaden.
He's got his other jersey, so he's wearing his brother's.
So, Jake took the snap. He was set upon pretty quickly, and he did well to just to get it off. It was behind the line of scrimmage.
Just yell up to him, say it's Russin.
Jaden Russin. And then he just motored, and I thought, oh, he's going to get 5 yards here. Then he had a first down. Then the next thing I know, he's running down the far sideline for getting for the touchdown. So great play, great execution, great hustle.
Aggressiveness against him.
Yeah, great hustle by Jaden Russin. And here's the extra point attempt from Sidney Krushka. The hold is good. Kick is up.
The extra point is good by Sidney Krushka.
7-0
Warriors.
7-0. So like a 45-yard pass. Jaden Russell. Nice play. You think he has 5 yards, then hey, he has a first down. The next thing you know, he's running for a touchdown. That was an exciting play.
We must apologize this time around because we are in the stands. We are not on top of a press box. So we're in the top row of the bleachers for Tunkhannock area.
Like back to receive for the Tigers, number 11, Riley Jones, and number 15, Nate Lord.
James is doing double duty as color commentary and administrator, so I appreciate that. So Jaden Russell, touchdown maker.
Number 43, Keegan Russell.
He got us the first down with the roughing the kicker call, and then he got us the touchdown. So Jaden Russell with a different number tonight, number 43. Here's the kick, and that's a nice deep boot, and that's going to come down inside the 10. That looks like Lord again. He's taking that same path, and he's spinning it around, and he's got some room before Adam Sigmund gets him around the ankles.
Nate Lord on the return, tackled by number 88, Adam Sigmund. The Tigers take over at the 35-yard line, first and 10.
35 for the Tigers. Let's start their second possession. They trail 7-0. And there's 9:12 left in this first quarter. Yeah, I can sit down. How you doing, all right?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Nice night. Not too cold yet. Under the harvest moon. Jack Chilson, three receiver set. He's got a single setback with him. He is going to hand off. That's Ty Conan, it looks like. And good penetration at
number
the back of the Warriors. I see Rich
Isinski.
I see Sean Kostak. I see Drew Maruk. I see Condry. So gang tackling by the Warrior defense.
Condry.
Just a little dive play.
11.
From the pistol formation, trying to get some positive yards. And right now, it's rough going on the ground for Tunkhannock. They bring up second and 11.
They delayed it a little bit too long.
Short drop by Chilson. He's looking over the middle for Baltasaitis again. Seemed like almost the same two plays as they ran.
Intended for Ben
Chilson.
Incomplete brings up a third and 12.
And a third and long now, and that's where Wyoming Air is going to want to put some pressure on Chilson. Flush him out of the pocket. Looks like Jaden Russin at one end, Blaze Sokashminik at the other defensive end. Four receiver set, still four Tunkhannock. Chilson, there's a give, and a little dive play. Nick Elko was able to
corral Tycoon. Carry tackled by number 69, Nicholas Elko. Brings up a fourth and seven.
That's a little curious call there, third and long, and Tunkhannock maybe trying to catch them in a wide set maybe and find some room and somebody makes breaks a tackle and gets a first down. But this is primarily a passing team. And you can't be in third and long all game. Here's the snap and the punt. It is a good one. It's going to come down at the 40. Another fair catch by Adam Sigmund.
And Jamal Zacharias with the punt. Fair caught.
The Warriors will have the ball back.
Adam Sigmund
at their own 29-yard line. 8:05 left in this first quarter, and they lead 7-0. It's just joining us on the first series. It looked like the Warriors were going to go three and out. Then Jaden Russin was roughed up on the punt attempt. 15-yarder put the ball into Tunkhannock territory.
Normally on a third and long, if you run into that type of situation, it's usually like a draw play or a screen, not like a power.
Right. And after the first play of that series, after the penalty, Jaden Russin, 45 yards on the screen play. Williams in the gun now, in the pistol. He will send Vincenzo Jambra in motion, and he's got it on a jet sweep. He's looking for some room around that left end. He cuts in and gets about 3 or 4 yards.
Carried by number 30.
Looks like number 80 for Tunkhannock.
Cabrera, tackled by number 80, Shane Woods.
Shane Woods. So gain of a
brings up a second and 10 for the Warriors.
Second and 6. So you've got positive yardage there. Mark that ball at the, looks like the 32-yard line. High formation now behind Jacob Williams. Rocco Pisano is set on your near side. There's a pitch, too. Looks like Tunkhannock is going to have the ball. They do.
Fumble on the play. Recovered by number 31, Michael Sickler.
Tigers.
First down, Tigers.
Big break for Tunkhannock.
At the 30-yard line.
So the Warrior defense will have to dig in now. But they give the Tigers this short field.
First down, looking for a shot.
Chilson has Nathan Lord and Ben Chilson on this near side. They're two of the top receivers for the Tigers. Wilson, Baltasarayas in motion, a little snap over his head. Now he's trying to get away from Blake Sokaszminnik. And he won't get away from, he's that on the sidelines.
Chilson on the keeper.
Kostak.
Tackled by number 20.
Shane Kostak. Blake Sokaszminnik did a good job of riding him to the sidelines. Then Sean Kostak.
No gain on the play, brings up a second and 10.
He's a little faster than I thought he was. He was get away from Blake, you gotta have some speed. So good pressure by the Warriors that time. Second and 10 now, 7:13 left in the first quarter. Chilson will kick a player in motion. Here's a give on a jet sweep. And he's got some room, and he breaks through. And if Rocco Pizzano doesn't get
Ben
an ankle
Chilson
tackle
the
there,
round.
Ben Chilson might have went
for a 9-yard gain.
Took it for
brings up a third and one.
That's a typical DB tackle in space.
Well, it saved the first down there. Saved the first down and probably a touchdown.
Chilson has some size to him, too.
Yeah. That's a step up from a punter kick.
Yeah, tackle. Nice D there by Rocco Pisano. So third and short here for Tunkhannock. 6:46 left in the first quarter. Looks like Chilson will send Baltasarayas in motion. Little gift to Conan. He's hit hard. And oh, it's a Chilson held it. And oh, it didn't fool. Yeah, didn't fool Drew Maruck. Didn't fool Nick Yelko.
Chilson on the keeper.
Yeah, it looked like a fumble, and that's what the Warriors started.
Tackled by number 15.
They didn't see it, so they're going to take ground.
I don't know what.
We're gonna have to like see that one in tomorrow morning on film.
Because all of a sudden, Chilson had it in his hands. It looked like he had it. In his
It was a
handoff to Conan.
I wasn't in on it, but because I wanted to get everything.
So it looks like maybe Tunkhannock got an extra down here. Fourth and 5. 5:57 left in the first quarter. They're gonna send four receivers. Oh, they're gonna get a little mix-up play here now. They're trying to get the Warriors in a bad matchup, but that's great coverage there. That's great coverage. Play so catch minute.
Chilson's pass intended for Jamal Zacharias incomplete. Turnover on downs. The Warriors take over.
So catch minute did a really good job of manning up there.
Coach Perbola, is he the head coach?
No, I think he's the offensive coach.
He's the offense. He came up with an interesting play there.
Good job, Warrior defense. And a turnover on downs, the Warriors will have it back.
Craig, what do you think about that play?
That was interesting. That was very interesting.
I think it's kind of early for that kind of play.
They had some offense. Well, you know, trying to change some momentum here.
Yeah.
Have the ball almost in the red zone.
Normally when you go.
That was probably engineered by a Warrior, though. That was engineered by a Warrior.
Something.
You have to understand.
We'll see what the Warriors do on this possession. Maybe try to grind out some yards. Try that Tunkhannock rushing defense. Looks like a little tighter sets now. Williams, a short drop, and he's looking on the sideline for Rocco Pisano. And just over his head, but he had a step on his man there, Jack Chilton.
Intended for Rocco Pisano, incomplete, brings up a second and 10.
That's going to be a
25.
Nice battle to watch tonight. Rocco Pisano against Chilson.
Jack Chilson with the coverage.
The Chilson brothers are both like 6'4", 6'5". So that gives them a little advantage in pass coverage. You really got to get past them. Second and 10 for the Warriors. How are we looking, all right? Got a little blur in it.
No, that's for me.
Oh, that's you, okay. Decent quality. Lee Sokashminik will be the end here. Make that right side the strong side. I formation. In the slot here is Adam Sigmund. Timeout.
Timeout taken by the Warriors.
Timeout, Warriors. That's their first.
We should explain a little bit about some of the connections at Tunkhannock, don't you think, Frank?
Oh, yeah.
The offensive coordinator for Tunkhannock.
Folks, let's give one more round of applause for our Tiger cheerleaders and the seniors that we celebrated tonight. Congratulations.
It was part of the 1983 championship team? Penn State? 1984.
No, it was 87.
87, you're right.
87, the
championship basketball. Against Miami.
Starting weak side offensive tackle. He has the ring.
And their guys are up
and
here in Tunkhannock.
Literally 20 yards from us. Like
they're a big part of the Tunkhannock program. So Warrior Nation travels well. And
that's why we were saying about an interesting play. Yeah. That was engineered by a Warrior, Mr. Prabowler.
They were looking for us.
Dr. Prabowler.
As we got into the stadium, they were looking for us, made sure we were well taken care of. We appreciate that.
We also should also know that there's a Michael Sickler
on the team this year.
Which is Mark's son.
He's been involved in a couple tackles already.
Yes, and the fumble recovery. Michael Sickler got
the
fumble.
So the Warriors packed in a little tighter here, maybe trying to get some running room. Williams, play action now, and he was looking for Drew Maruk. And
Jacob Williams pass, intended for number 21, Drew Maruk. Incomplete.
Riley
Brings
Jones.
Brings up a third and 10
nice
from the 25.
This Tunkhannock defense is they're aggressive. They're quick.
Very aggressive.
Number 59 checks in there for Tunkhannock. That's Jaden Kozlowski. No penalty. What's the call there? Neutral zone?
Personal foul on the Tigers.
Yeah, you can't do that when you're down at home early. Trying to change the momentum.
After the 15-yard penalty, we'll bring up a three.
Especially
did anybody see anything on that?
Especially after an incomplete pass. I don't think somebody said something after the game or after the play. So the Warriors get a break there at 15 yards. They're at their own 40-yard line now. Single setback is Will Harris.
Sean Meter brings up a second
there.
And seven.
Try to get a little closer here. Second and seven for the Warriors after the game by Harris is put to the far side. He's back and healthy. That's going to be good for the Warriors. Short drop. Jacob Williams is looking for Lee Sokashminik.
Jacob Williams
got help up there a little bit.
Number 15,
that's the kind of
in coverage number 27, Connor Elgin brings up a third and seven from the 43 for the Warriors.
Looks like it's been tough running a little bit so far.
Oh, they're stacking the box.
Yeah. So you got to play a little some wider.
I'd expect a lot of play action, double
moves. Well, our guys have shown that they could get open in these first three games. Now we got Rocco Pisano and Adam Sigmund.
split to the far side. Jaden Russin is on that left side as the tight end. He'll kick Drew Maruk in motion. He's deep and he'll take a short drop. Now he's looking for Jaden Russin again.
Williams pass is covered by the 43, Keegan Russin. Incomplete, brings up a 4th and 7.
So it looks like the Warriors are taking short drops now. Just trying to see if they can get a mismatch somewhere in the secondary. But at some point, they're going to want to establish a running game if they can. Jaden Russin now will be back to punt. That looks like maybe Nathan Lord back at his own 23-yard line. Here's the snap, and it's a little bit end over end, and you might just have to let it roll there. And it's going to take a Warrior bounce down to the 22-yard line.
Keegan Russin with the punt.
That's where Tunkhannock will take over.
Down at the 21-yard line, the Tigers take over. First and 10.
First quarter. So we got the laptop is good. We could find something to plug this into.
We have to unplug that. So we have to do at halftime what we do the big clip.
That S3 phone?
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
We'll be good. We'll do that at halftime.
Yeah.
And then we'll be good for the rest of the game.
You have your charger? You have your charger for your phone? Because we'll flip it over. We can't unplug this now because we'll lose signal.
I'm good right now.
At halftime, we're going to put the power strip in.
4:41 left. Tigers, I think they're still looking for their first down, aren't they?
I think they got one already.
Pistol formation, single setback. It looked like they have a wing back there with Chilson now. As soon as they sent him in motion, they blew a whistle.
Legal formation.
Delay
game.
Which is unusual on a first down.
Delay game on the Tigers.
But it looked like they had something different that they
set up. Lose the ball back 5 yards. We'll bring up a 1st and 15.
A little longer to get set. So Tigers dig themselves a little hole here. 1st and 15 now. The coaches are saying, the officials said they tried to do a quick snap.
He didn't get it off.
No, he's saying he didn't set the ball down for him to run the play.
Oh.
So the officials are conferring, but it'd be very unusual for them to wave it off after they already imposed it. Well, I don't know if the officials know that we're on limited battery power here. I don't know if they care. Well, they're conferring. They want to get it right. He's going to make it till halftime. I should have discussed that with them when we passed them on the way in. Yeah, it's unusual that they'd wave it off. Coach McRae's not happy.
He literally just got done saying the refs, the penalties are killing him, but yet he's about to get one himself.
1st and 15 now. Yeah, he's got. Yeah, just gotta.
Cooler heads.
Just gotta snap up the. In strapping, get after it. So same formation now. Motion and play action. And he was looking for
Chilson's pass, incomplete, intended for Shane Wood.
Shane Wood.
Defended by number 88, Adam Sigmund. Brings up a 2nd and 15 from the 16.
Shane Wood, I don't have stats on him, but he looks in a 6'2", got some good height. Tunkhannock has a lot of receivers with a little bit of height. Chilson now, short drop. Now he's under a little pressure and he's looking for Lord over the middle. He's got him. Oh, incomplete.
Pass intended for Nate Lord.
Good hit there by Leo Harris.
It was perfect timing.
Covered by number
perfect
22,
timing.
Leonard Harris.
That's where Leo
brings up a 3rd and 15.
He's a force in that defensive backfield. And he kept all the action in front of him. And like Greg said, it was just perfect timing to separate the receiver from the ball.
That's very hard to do.
He's up a 3rd and long now.
Quarterback from Tunkhannock has great vision. He's made the plays happen.
He's been at this for three. He's been at this for 3 or 4 years. There's another 3rd and long handoff, and he's got some yardage there.
A lot of his throws.
Carried by number 44, Bobby Schultz. Tackled by number 82, Michael Clark. Will bring up a 4th and 4.
So not a give up, but another 3rd and long where they went to the ground.
And I guess Jamal Zacharias back to punt.
A 3rd and short.
They're playing this with a punt fake.
The video keeps freezing.
Oh, okay.
Zacharias punt down by number 35, Jacob Baltasidis. The Warriors take over at the 32-yard line, 1st and 10. 7-0 Warriors with 3:53 to go in the first quarter.
Okay, so I just changed the sleep settings on the laptop, so that should improve that. Warriors at their own 32-yard line. Yashai and Maruk are in the I formation. Rocco Pisano on the near side. Turning, give to Maruk. He's looking for some room. He's got some room. And he'll push and he'll drag. Tunkhannock tacklers for another 3 or 4 yards.
Number 22, Leonard Harris.
Leo Harris.
Tackled by number 11, Riley Jones.
He carried by Leo.
Nice to see. Gain of 10, good enough for a Warriors first down.
He gets a first down. Just got enough for the first down. Up to the Warrior 44-yard line, 1st and 10. Jaden did it. 1st and 10 for the Warriors. After the 10-yard run by Harris. He's in the I formation with Gashai. Oh, and it looks like they jumped.
Flag on the play. Warriors with a false start. Brings the ball back 5 yards. Will bring up a 1st and 15.
I'm gonna be in this first 12 minutes. Team's got to clean that up. How you doing, cameraman? Good.
Wonderful.
Rocco Pisano split to that far side. Yeah, it's a little different look than being in the stands. I'm usually up on top of the press box. Yashai and Harris. There's a carry by Harris. He's got some room up midfield. Splits. 2 Tunkhannock defenders. He's got another
number
first
22,
down.
Number 22, Leonard Harris on the carry. Tackled by number 15, Nate Ward.
Give him a lot of credit for holding over the ball.
Another nail. Warriors first down.
We have a Tunkhannock Tiger will get some treatment here. So 2 carries, 2 first downs for Leo Harris, and he looks really good. As you know, Geisinger is one of our big sponsors this year in 2020 for all Wyoming area athletic programs. As we enter cold and flu season, you want to know where your pharmacies are and what your options are. So go to geisinger.org and click on their pharmacy link to see a pharmacy near you, or you can even make arrangements for mail order to get your meds sent to your home.